Hello, and today we're going to be looking at these two shillings. One of them's from 1934, and the other's from 1944. Both of them are 50% silver. One of them's from King George V, and the other's from King George VI. As you can see, they're slightly different designs. This one's a bit more cleaner, while this one's a bit more crowded. Personally, I prefer the crowded one a bit more. Here, you can see they added the House of Windsor Rose. Moved the date to the sides of the lion and crown. The crown representing the monarchy, and the lion representing England and Scotland. You can see the design is slightly different on these two, despite the obvious change. The font of the writing is slightly different. You can see the G on George here is obviously a bit more fancy than the G on George here. And this one's a bit more well-worn than this one, because this one's got a few scratches on it, that's it. This one doesn't really have any scratches. It's just worn down over the time it's been in circulation. The 1934, in uncirculated condition, it's worth about £41 plus. And the 1944 one is worth about... it's worth about £7.45 plus in uncirculated condition. This one is probably about in extra fine, so it's about £15. And this one's about in a uncirculated condition, so it's about £5.60. You can see here they actually shortened down the writing so they could add a bit more. They reduced the day to a D, the gra into a G, and the Brit, representing Britannia, into a BR. And then this stayed the same, as you can see, and they kept Rex. Both of these coins are relatively common to find, and they both have a reeded edge.